to whoever is out there. I have to turn off my sound that I already had. My god, I have started to be so organized and so good at this. Just been doing it now for half a year, finally. So just be hanging it on a little bit to see if somebody is coming on. Hopefully I won't be sitting here alone, but if I do that, that's okay. Martina, hi! Good to see you, girl. How are you today? I'm actually quite good. I've just been chilling and relaxing and hardly really done anything. I don't know what I've done this Sunday. I've had some takeaway dinner, actually. For once, but from that I've just been watching TV and I've been coloring a little bit, sleeping. I want to get to the dentist. When are you going to the dentist, Martina? And hi, Nia, welcome. Pickle, Salina, Christine, Dev, my man, yay, Veronica, hey, and Nick and Tina, my sister and brother-in-laws are here as well. Oh, awesome, Pamela. And Dorothy, hi, Starbucks! Welcome, welcome, Pickle! I can keep on. So many that are coming in, awesome. Elizabeth, hi! I have a little bit different setup than I have used to, so I don't really see my screen as good as I used to. So if I'm kind of off arena or something, I hope that some of you can shout that me. Hopefully I will see it. And the lighting actually looks good, so that's good. Oh, and again, notifications comes and cover half the chat. That's not good. Anyways, it's awesome to see all of you here, and I hope that you all have a wonderful, wonderful Sunday. And for for the ones who actually want to know and to listen to it, I am actually on today's episode of Colorista's podcast. So for all of those that want to hear the interview with me, you should go and get to Podbean and seek out Passionista Colorista and listen to her podcast. It's a coloring podcast that she has had for a while. So so it's quite, yeah, okay. So it's over there on Podbean or on other apps or stuff where you listen to your podcast. You love this book, Dev. I'm sure that you will get it eventually. It might be that Mardel actually shows up here as well, so you can then ask him and talk to him about how to get this. But I know that it's on Amazon US, or I mean Amazon.com, the American now, because this one was sent to me from there. Oh, is it out of stock? Okay, then I'm sure that they will print it quite fast, because he has tried to put it out there like 2 times before, and the paper has been rubbish. Now, Mardel doesn't like the paper that he had in his earlier books, like Sirena. He feels he couldn't color on it, so he didn't want this textured paper. And then they actually found some paper that he liked, and then we're back. I hope that we all are back, because I was buffering. Then it looks like it. Hopefully we will stay connected. I don't know why it did that. Well, anyways, so he also then got some in October. And then I was contacted by his publisher in last month, November actually, and Darlene has gotten me one as well, so I'm expecting another one coming. So we will do a giveaway of this book when I get the other one here, but it hasn't arrived yet, and I have to pick up Aria because she wants up. Yeah, come down. You come down. No, she did not. She wants to. Lay now, so I can't do that. She has to go to his or her father. You have never seen this before. Well, Mardel has several books out. He has some digital ones. This one was his first one, which is Mermaids. I can show you a couple of his pictures in here. I've done this sleeping one. And he has Mascara. This one is Mascara, which are all women with masks, or I did the title page once upon a time. These two came out in 2017. I've also done this girl. Yeah, so this is the style, and he also, I have done this one. So this is the style of those two books, and then he also has, he actually now has two Christmas books out. The first one was Silent Night. Now this is on a different type of paper, it's more copy paper. And I don't know if they are going to print this one on better paper, but I think not, because he has another Christmas book out just now. So, oh, Rosemary, so on eBay, 73 with the shipping, that wasn't that bad. And hi, Beth. And hi to everybody. Charlotte, hi. And of course, Rosemary, and everybody else that I have missed. I'm so sorry, but you are all very welcome. So I want to, I have this galley. So I want to color a page in this book. You can see the full flip on my channel. I posted that one yesterday. But I want to, let me see, this one, I want to do this, this girl, I don't know the English word for what we call var, but it's some kind of, is it ram? Well, she reminds it, reminds me of it. Hi, darling. Hi. Welcome. Anika. Hi. Yeah, I guess Taurus is the sign, the zodiac sign, because all of these are zodiac, the yak signs. So I will just add or get a water palette so I can actually put under this, so I can flip, have it a little bit tipped like that. So, So I will be working today with, everything. I have out some Graphitint, I have of course my Inktense, I have some Inktense watercolors in pens, and I have of course pencils that we might get later on. I don't know quite how far we will get today, but we will keep working on it on Tuesday and maybe Sunday or next Sunday if we have to. Anyways, so first of all, I want to start doing her background because that needs time to dry up, and I am buffering not only on my laptop and okay. Well, as long as it's just one of my things, then I think that we are okay. So I want a really dark background and a kind of a golden, I don't know if it's a sun or a moon. Well, let's make it a moon. A moon can be kind of a warm yellow in the summer, and it can be blue and cold in winter. But this is a summer picture, so I want to have a warm sun, and I think for that the mustard in Inktense would be a nice color. That is, if I can of course find it. This one, mustard. Mustard is number. Yeah, what is the 70? Let me see, mustard is 700. Oh. Hi, Kate! Welcome, sweetie! Good to see you. I hope that you are okay. That's good, Elizabeth. Thank you. So, Nick and Tina got some happy mails. What did you get? You have to share the joy with us. Because we all like it when people get happy mails. It's actually quite fun that the most viewed videos on YouTube are unboxing and happy mails. So it's obvious that we all like to see what other people are getting. So I'm gently putting down some color on the paper. I have a light layer further in, and quite not heavy layer, but it is heavier than the inside I kind of have on the outside. Kind of, I will show you what I mean. Oh, and again, notifications comes up. Let me see, I missed Derwent Colorsoft's awesome. And they've got some Copics in skin tone. That's awesome. And a Boba Fett desk ornament. Awesome. Awesome. And I sure hope that you will like the color shops, because I do. They were my first artist graded pencils, and I really like them. They are soft, but not as soft as very soft. Just having a light layer pulled a little bit in. So I just got a little bit pigment to work on when I work my way in on this sun or this moon. Just adding a little bit more further on the outside, so I have a little bit more pigment there to work with. Because then I can kind of pull this pigment down to the center as I go, or as I'm wetting it. I need to scroll up a little bit. I get asked that in Padom. Well, if you do that, sweetie, I think that you need a bigger screen. Oh, is it pickle awesome? I believe that my son is it as well. I think so. I'm not that big into the horoscopes and zodiac signs, but so I'm getting streaks, so I have to be careful and be a little bit more light-handed. It is kind of hard since I'm kind of wanting to be fast as well, because I don't want to keep you here like forever, and now actually I want to get something done in a couple of hours and not be here colliding for 2 hours and nothing shows like that, maybe. Yeah, I guess so. Oh, I'm pickle. let me see. I'm taking out my watercolor. Here you see now what I mean with putting down more pigment on the outside than on the inside. When I'm wetting this now, I believe that I have to turn it and work my way around it. Checking to see if it's wet, and it's actually quite wet. I think it's a little bit too wet. But at least then we will see if this paper takes water well or not. Because you can't really feel that before you actually take water on it. And I actually have quite a lot of water, and it looks like it's taken it quite well. It is, I'm actually soaking this paper. So to be careful not to pull this color into my little girl here. This Bull Taurus girl. I think that she was just so cute. Well, thank you, Deb. That's awesome that you want them to give me a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. So thank you so much. I'm letting it on this moon. I'm not careful of getting everything even, because when I look at the moon, it has patterns on it. When I was little, I always saw that there was kind of landscape on the moon, and I used to imagine how it was up there, if we could. Now I know that we actually can't. Hi, Jesse, welcome. And Susan, hi. I know that we can't live on the moon, or at least not in that form that we can live here. But anyways, it was fun to imagine how life would be if we actually could live here. Now, I was a child with a lot of imagination. I am today a child with a lot of imagination. So still, I guess that something doesn't really pass. Though I have learned not to tell everybody about what my sick mind always comes up with. But of course, all of you all already know that it's not always that I manage to keep everything I'm thinking for myself. And I have to turn this, so for those of you who are getting motion sick easily, I'm sorry. And it sounds like my foster son is actually getting a lot of messages now, or all the occasions. He has like 500 games on his phone, so I might have to put that somewhere else if it's going to keep making that noise. Oh, you did, Elizabeth. Thank you. I haven't listened to it, and I don't know if I actually dare to, because I hate hearing my own voice. I never watch back my videos either, both because I hate my own voice and I hate to listen to mom's uttering. I haven't listened to the podcast yet, but I guess that I should. I just have to, dare to. I'm sure it's a good one, because Isabella always does an amazing job. She's a good journalist, and she has always made good podcasts. I have listened to her for quite some time. There we have this. And Deb, I might have mentioned you on the podcast as well. Darlene, I don't quite know, because I think that you need to have, I listen to podcast on something that is called Podbean. But I'm sure that you can listen to the podcast on other apps and stuff. And I can post a link to her YouTube, or if anyone of my mods can put a link to Nista Colorista's YouTube channel. I'm sure that she has link to the podcast, or where you can listen to it. Oh, you don't thank me yet, because you don't know what I said. So you might want to hear what I said before you actually thank me. I wasn't mean. but I did tell them all about us. So now they know. I need something in the sky, but I don't quite know if I want use the Graphitint maybe. Because the Graphitint really has this awesome shadow color. Also, I don't know if I actually. Oh my god. I believe that I want her here as of to be gray and brownish, maybe. Caroline, hi, welcome. So, oh my god. Something dark. That paints gray. Oh, we have this gorgeous deep indigo in the Inktense. Now I wish that I actually had that in the tin, but I don't. This lacks a really dark one. So, and I should make a note to myself and actually get some of those. Looks deep indigo there. That is, this is deep indigo. I should get some of those. Looks as well and put into my watercolor tin. I have more of those as well, and now I don't want to. Yeah, well, it doesn't matter. So I want the darkest dark indigo to be on the outer edges, and then a little bit lighter towards the moon. Coloring from this angle might not be quite the best, but we will try. And my little finger are just going out of itself. Well, I am a woman, so I guess that it's legal to be coloring with a pinky sticking out. At least when you have to be quite fast doing it. This one here. That. Oh no, Susan, I'm sorry to hear that you're not quite well yet. We should have this. It's called shadow. And I'm sorry for the further sound that or maybe I should just clip it out. Really. Is this shadow? Yes, this is shadow. This is from the. Okay, Graphitint. Pencils. And you can mix your Inktense with other kind of watercolors. That is perfectly fine. This need to be like in as well because that is on the back. This one. This is just a lighter blue gray color. We're gonna put in here. Dusty, welcome. Tracy, hi. I don't think that I said hi to you. Oh, look at that little hat and pillar. I love those small bugs that he puts in here and there. So I will put them down, that one there. Then I actually think that I want to bring out that mustard again because that was kind of pink. Oh, I mean yellowish. So we need a little glow, just putting or adding some in it, like here and there. Now you actually can't see that much of it yet, but hopefully it will give some glow when we wet this. And if not, then we can go over with some pencils or watercolors or something else and give it a glow that I might want. So again, I have to work my way around. I'm testing to if it's wet enough, and it was. And I'm putting them in skin. The rike, so I'll have to clean it up. Just pull it a little bit out like that. So. This Taurus down here needs to have a nice dark background. Hi Sharon, welcome. Good to see you. Happy Sunday. I hope that you all are having a wonderful Sunday. Like that. This water that I'm having that I have in my water. Just now, it's water with some oxgall in it. Oxgall makes the watercolor color flow better and keeps the paper wet longer. Which I also mentioned in or on the podcast, if it's there. I didn't cut it out. This is a tip that I got from Sargot Hunter, actually. And it's an awesome tip, because that makes me able to work with the water water longer than I could be pour this tip. I don't want all of this to be totally even, because this is a night sky with clouds or something in the back. So it's not supposed to be totally even. And it makes, or it gives it a little bit more interest. I said oxgall. Spencer and Newton has one. There are several variants. I know where Schmincke has it. And Spencer and Newton is the one that I got. It's called oxgall. Oxgall, basket means liquid. It doesn't really say anything. It just puts to, you know, 34 drops in one cup of water. This has changed everything, and it makes water colors so much, much easier than it used to be. So that, Elizabeth, is what I meant. Ox gold. It's something from the gold leather of an ox or something. I'm sure you can find out what it is by googling it or asking some kind of artist who actually knows. And it seems like watercolor artists have been using this for years and not told us. And as I have I'm watching more and more kind of more of a artist channels and stuff, I'm picking up things like that, because not that we aren't artists, but there are the difference being a regular colorist who are coloring just for a hobby, and those who actually are educated as artists. And they have so much knowledge that actually, oops, damn it. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't really mean to curse. Hello. They have so much. Diane, hi, welcome, sweetie. I hope that you got my email. I sent you an email, I think it was yesterday morning before I went out. This is where I did the birds. Oh, thank you, Sharon. You don't know how to reset your name, Diane. You will then change your name on all of your Google Google accounts things. But you can do it through YouTube as well by clicking your picture or your name, as you see. I don't know if you are on a laptop or a tablet or a phone, but somewhere you should have your profile. And Sargat, hi, welcome. And then you should be able to go into your profile and your settings and change your name. I don't know what it's called there in English. If it says change nickname or something, but it's something like that. At least it should be. So I'm just wetting this big area, like in one line without lifting my pencil up. To in an attempt to get it a little bit more even. As I said, it doesn't have to be totally even, and it probably, or it can't be maybe this small. But just share. Natalie, hi, and I'm sorry that I'm covering a bit up. As I said when I started, I have a new setup for my camera, and I'm trying to see if it's working. But if that makes me cover up half the picture all the time, then of course I can't use it. So welcome to all of you. I hope that I have said hi to everybody. If I haven't, then hi and welcome. You are all welcome here. And I'm just working my way down. Like that. I'm almost done. Maybe I will actually turn it so you can see even better what I'm doing. That's kind of half the reason why we are here, isn't it? Thank you, Dusty. Oh, you do. You have the 48 set of the Derwent watercolors, Diane. I'm so happy for you. Watercolor pencils are so much fun. Though the Derwent ones are not my favorite because I like more vibrant tones, but they are awesome for the earthy tones. They are really good. Some of the artist channels that I recommend, Sarga Tantor is one of them. She teaches us a lot of things, from color mixing and to the drawing that she has now. But also, oh my god, I can't remember. I will have to open YouTube or just to check so I don't pronounce his name wrong, because it's and I can actually link you as well, because he has really nice tutorials and stuff for Lauvan is awesome. He has two tutorials for markers and watercolors, and he has really long rims, and he has short tutorials. So now the link comes up as Sir Kite 92. I have to check that. It is Lauvan. He is one of my favorites. And yeah. also, I do like Lindsay Perugal. After we all know her. And of course, all of the big ones are awesome. But there are also several smaller channels that are quite good. It's all about what you really want. Yeah, okay. So Sarga doesn't have color mixing videos up now or anymore, but she will make some new ones and post them. That's good. And she also has videos who kind of teaches you how or to see the thing. Yeah, the art Sherpa is also awesome. Though she does mostly acrylic, I think. Now, I don't quite know what kind of mediums you are looking for. But there are several channels out there for different things, and you can always pick up something. Mm. Yeah, Diane, congratulations! Yoo-hoo! The event bought the color pencils. Yay! That's awesome. Oh, how, oh, this juniper, this is actually a pink one. Well, I think that I want this oak color for her here or something. It's like I don't really remember them all when people ask me. I'm like, oh my god. But afterwards, now I have taken out this oak. Because I want this to be my base color for her hair. And let's just see how that works. And of course... Jerry Sartorama has this YouTube channel as well, where they have different subjects every time, or not every time. Often it is watercolors, but they also have pastels or oils and oil pastels. Lot of different things. They, of course, they sell all of this stuff, but they also show you how to use a lot of it, and it's like a mini course just by watching them. So here is Artorama. If you need a link, then I can get you that as well. Yeah, Elizabeth, that's a good idea, actually, that you can go and watch who I'm following. Because I don't remember everyone when people ask me like that. And in the podcast, I should have mentioned how Sargot Hunter there. But I didn't, and when it was over, I was like, oh my god, I should have mentioned her because she is so versatile. She shows you a lot of the different things. She learns you how to and she tests us out a lot of stuff. I like this color for her hair. This I don't know if I have actually have pencils in my, or pencils that I can use to shade and stuff. But I do like this color. Should I love the big box in a circle? What are you talking about? And who? Which box in a circle? I'm not what? Oh, Tegan has asked for stuff. Oh, Sharon, what book this is? And I'm sorry that I didn't see it. This is the new book to Mardel Rubio, the Zodiacolor, which is out now. And thank you, Kadis-Satin. You can mix all of your watercolor mediums. Really, you don't have to be using just one and one. And Jan, who now has gotten the watercolor pencils from Derwent, she can use them to gather with other watercolor stuff, mediums. And actually, me mixing in the Inktense will also make it easier going over with a wet medium later on if I want to, because then it won't lift that easy. So it's kind of setting it as well when you are mixing Inktense with it, because the ink will help it stay some kind. The sharpest has a big circle of markers and a huge pack of cells. Oh yeah, right. I have seen that on Kellas Olsson, I think it was. So they have this huge, or yeah, not that huge, but kind of a big pack with sharpest in a circle. And only 5 euros. Wow, that was cheap. So while this dry, we should do some start on her skin. Now I don't know if I want to make a blue base on this girl, because I kind of want her a little bit cold. I don't want her to be all pink and kind of warm, because she has this really warm sun, or the moon, I mean, at the back. So maybe, or no, or maybe not. Let's actually, what is this? Well, this is the shadow color lying down here. I do think that I actually can try to go in and put a small watered down base of waters, or blue, I mean. This is the bright blue, but then I want to use another pencil. Brush, oh my god, my. Yes, so just to make it faster, and I will just put this light blue layer that might can be a little bit too blue actually. Oops. I'm taking with me in the book and all. So we will just oops. That. So she might look quite ugly right now, but don't worry, we will make her pretty again once we add pencils on top. She will be nice. This is just to make her skin a little bit more cold, because I always use kind of hot colors for skin, like peach colors. So, and those colors actually has a lot of pinks, and they are very warm. And but this girl, I don't want that warm skin, so I put down a base of blue. So I just don't worry, I won't make an avatar out of her like that. Yeah, and Phibs are parents in the box. I will just clean up that one. Of course, I should have put some on her small ears, actually. Yeah, Elizabeth, she might look like an avatar now, but she won't be. But I do think that we should actually use some natural brown and burnt ochre to go over this terry. So I will have some of this burnt yellow ochre, which from the Derwent Inktense palette, and just some of this natural brown there. Oh yeah, Me Too Avatar is awesome. It's so amazing and it's so well made, and the story about it in it is also, and the moral of that movie, I love it. It's such an amazing film. That's actually one of those I have seen multiple times. Oops. Picking up a little bit of this darker. Put that in. A little bit here and there, maybe. Oops, sorry. That is tripod thing is actually too close now. So I'm what is that? Is that tree or a, yeah, I think that it is. Okay. Thankfully it was nothing that I had to worry about. This yellow ochre down here, and I will add some of this darker brown under this caterpillar to make some shadow, and that shadow is just running all the way down. I think I have to, come on, don't, you're not supposed to stay there. Just suck some of it up, take it away. Mardel, you came. Awesome. Hello, hello, my friend. How are you? And it's got to be nighttime at your, or where you are now, Mardel. But I'm so happy to see you, and I'm happy that you had the time to pop by. Thank you so much. That's awesome. And don't worry that this girl is blueing her face now, because she won't be. I will fix her and make her pretty. Hi Bella, welcome. And everybody should say hi to Mardel, which is the one who made this gorgeous book. He is an amazing artist and an amazing man as well. I need a little bit more of this darker one. Down there. I'm so happy that you could make it here, Mardel. Thank you so much. So we'll just put this base down here. And now I feel that I really need to hurry up on that skin, because Mardel is here and I can't show him this ugly girl. Oh, Mardel knows that I will make her pretty. In some shadows here and there as well, just to use up some of that paint that we have here. And we'll use pencil later on to make it. Oops, I don't want that moon to be brown like that. So, then we can put this away, I think, like that. You have all of his books, Helena, that's awesome. I think I have about all of them as well. And thanks to Darlene, she has gotten me several of them. I think I have 3 from her now or something. Well, Diane, she is cold, but I don't want to keep her like this. We are going to make her have skin color. I just wanted a cold undertone. Because when you wash skin, some skin has a colder undertone that are more blue. Some skin tones are green, some skin tones like Asians has a lot of yellow, and Afro-American has darker reds or even purple or violets undertone in their skin. And I don't want to make this girl she probably is Asian, so maybe I should have made a yellow undertone, but I don't want that because it's my book and I want to make her with a blue undertone. Yeah, I know, Caroline. He always does. And now he is flipping his food bowl, so I need to refill that a little bit. I will be right back. That's how it is when I have a cat as my boss. So there. There you see. Dev, it worked itself out. I'm sure that Mardel can help you. She's still quite wet, so I need to dry her up. So I will have to load dry her. So for those who don't or don't like the sound, you have to mute my video now, and I will wave like this when it's done. So here it goes. There we are done, and you can put this on again. Yeah, Pickle, you have a cat boss too. And hi, Shaleen, welcome. So good to see you. Are you coming live later on? Or in an hour or so? Or not really an hour, any longer. Now it's like 50 minutes. So for skin, I just have to pull out some of this colors because I really have no room for having all of this on my desk as well as everything else. So for skin, I have, where did it go? I have picked out the burnt ochre, we have peach, and we have light peach. This is in Prismacolor. And they are Christine's. Several of them are, because I have several of them in PDF. So I'm taking this, I call it a burnt ochre. Put them down in the shaded areas. Now you see, Prismacolor covers the blue color, but that's totally fine because it will still give it an undertone of blue and and a little bit colder tone, and then it has done its job. And this with undertone are really amazing and kind of a big thing in the art world. Now I have followed one artist for a while. He always starts out with green skin. And that skin that he, when he's done, is just amazing. And he does that with every medium that he does. He does oil and pastels. And it just looks amazing. So I'm just toning it down a little bit as well. Really light hand outside. Going around the face. Okay, thank you, Mardel. Thank you, thank you. It's just the moon that is done, really. But I'm happy that you like it. Just pulling it out a little bit. I might have to go in and darken that up later. But that is something that we have to see when we are done. How much darker we want to go. Hopefully I don't Oh, thank you, Pickle. Yeah, there you see Mardel has his books in PDF files as well. So you can jump over and buy those and download the PDF file and take them out on the paper that you like, which is really awesome. I have several books that I do that with. Because I like to have some on both color papers. I'm just marking in the shadowed areas, which is then of course around the face and under the nose, and that's that thing there. And the eyelids, and under the lip, of course. If you are not very sure also where to put, for example, her chin, you can mark it out a little bit like that in the darkest tones. So. Oh, you are not Shaleen. Okay, well then I don't have to rush it, I guess. Unless Dev is wanting to jump on. As it sounds like he wants to. I think that I also want to mark a little bit out where her cheeks are going to be. Not making that very dark yet, because we will go in later and add more. Then I have switched on to the peach. And Mardel, I have to say that this paper is very good paper to color on. It actually takes my water. This is Inktense and watercolors, so it actually takes the water quite well as pencils. So I like this paper, and I'm sure that you will like this paper as well if you, or when you color on it, or if you, or I'm sure that you already have. working my way around, just going over the darkest tone that I put down this shadowed areas, and are pulling this peach a little bit more to the center of the face, as I always do. Hi Nikki, welcome, good to see you. Oh, Miss Magical, oh, you are so sweet. Thank you, Nikki. Now this is why I love you. You always say those nicest things. Well, of course, not only because of that, but one of the reasons. Trying to pull some of this color a little bit down. So for those who are not sure in how to sculpture face, this is one way where you can do it. As you go. I forgot to add a little bit of this one there, and I want to have a little bit there. Now, noses are always hard. I don't know what it is about noses, but they are always killing me. Oh, you are going to London later. Pet help this afternoon. Awesome, Pickle. You can learn skin, and you should learn skin if you really want to. And you have been coloring for such a long time, so you already know all the basics. So I'm sure that it wouldn't take you that hard time to actually learn it. I am going back in with the darkest one again, just around the enhanced or enlarging, darken up the darkest tones a little bit more. Working my way around. Probably you still can see it when I'm working up here. Or hope that I don't cover it all. That, and then again to the peach. So now we have two layers of this burnt ochre, and we have two layers of peach. I'm just pulling this peach further in. Now, I did not do this. Yes, again. Should actually have a little bit of a sharper point, but we'll manage. You don't think you can splish with skin? Oh my god, I can show you. With watercolor you can splish and splush with skin, and you can make skin like in any color that you want. If you haven't seen some really awesome watercolor paintings with beautiful women, but and with skins within all kind of colors, then I will have to show you. Amongst the artists that I linked earlier, Lauvan has some really amazing watercolor portraits of women with skin where he is blushes and splotches. Kind of. Like that. Now this actually look quite pale on my computer. I hope that it doesn't look that light when it comes to you. Because it really isn't. And if it doesn't, I just have to turn off this one lamp to check if it shows better. Oh, it didn't really work. Why won't it show the skin as I... Thank you, Diane. Thank you so much. Hi, Cassandra. Welcome. Love your name. I just need something pink to put in the cheeks a little bit so she can have that. What do we want? Do we want this one? Mahogany, that's kind of quite a red one. From Australia, oh my god. Awesome, we have people from all over the world now. I love it. I mean, I just picked out, oh my god, that cat. I picked up the mahogany red. Now he is fed, now he wants some cuddle, I guess. But he will have to wait. I will not give him that now. So I'm just putting down this mahogany. A little bit gently. I just hope that I don't make her all pinkish. Going in with the light peach and blending all of that in. And putting some color down. And we should really color that nose a little bit more. So, there. Now we did lose some of those highlights around her mouth and those two lines going down from the nose, but we will get that back. So I'm just using this light peach to blend everything out. Kind of burnishing. At least those parts where I know that I won't add anything more, like this cheek parts. It's quite hard to remember that the English word for these parts are cheeks and this is chin, because in Norwegian we call this part chin. This is hake, but this is actually a chin. Yeah, I guess Nala looked for my cats because she can hear them or hear him. The girls are sleeping, but my big male is up and he is the one who is always howling. Now the other two can sometimes, but not like him. So now we have to work a little, work our way in on this nose. Maybe a little bit darker actually under the nose, because this part will are in more of a shade than the top. Like that, and then the peach again, we will work that up, work that down a little bit as well. And then the light peach, over, blending it out so it looks smooth and nice. So that is coming on after me. You love this face, Christine. Thank you. Thank you, Nikki. You are all so nice. Yeah, I told you we'd make her pretty. And she's not completely done yet because we still have something that we have to do, but I'm happy that you like her so far. And yes, Gary, she looks good. Considering this blue skin that we started with, I will try to lift up so you can actually can see why I put this blue undertone. Hopefully, or maybe I actually can zoom in, maybe that is better, because maybe I will get shadow if I lift it up, or maybe not, I don't know. Hopefully you can see the blue shining through, like on her, or the top of her cheeks, like this part. When I look at it in real life, it looks like she has veins under her skin. So hopefully you can see that. So when you look at her in real life, it also actually looks like real skin. And the undertones is kind of the secret between a nice skin and a really nice skin. Because you don't have to put undertones on, and I doesn't do that all the time. It's just now and then whenever I kind of feel like it. But like this girl, I really wanted to look nice because I knew that Mardel would or might come on. So I want to make her pretty for him, so I don't ruin his gorgeous art. Well, I know that that is silly of me, because it is my book and I can do whatever I want, but well, yeah, and this is what I want. Maybe a little bit more peach higher up, so it doesn't look so, or the transition isn't so hard. Now we lost some highlights there, and I think that maybe we can use this Prismacolor white on top, just to clean the tip, because I used it on some red strawberry. Oh, she does look like Prickle Welsh, really. Thank you. And hi, Ashley. Welcome. Hi, Blue. I will try to get back those highlights by using this white Prismacolor, also to her lip line. Should be whiter. And part of that one. But it won't that much. No, it won't. So then I guess that we have to use a gel pen later on, but then we'll have to do that, and I will use the same mahogany red for her lips like I did that I used in her cheeks. Yeah, cheeks. Oh my god, I have to think every time if what it's called. So I will give her some lips. And I also have learned that the top lip always will be darker than the under lip. Because the underlip is fuller and bigger than the underlip. I need more pencils. I need something. I don't know. I don't want a quite like madly pink. I want her to look kind of natural. Maybe. Oh, that looks too dark. Oh my god. This is hard. What color do I want her lips actually? Maybe I will use at least some of this rose, which is a gorgeous color. Add some bit here and there. And I should actually have a longer tip on that one. Thank you, Essie. Yeah, okay, Mardel. Have a wonderful day. And thank you so much for coming. You are awesome. Thank you so much, Mardel. You are awesome. Artist and talent and an awesome guy. So thank you so much for coming. Yeah, Pamela, I know. thank you, Sharon. Thank you. I know that I am the boss of my book. I also want to put a little bit of pink inside her eyes here. And a little bit pink right in there. So of course I can do what I want, but I also want to make it nice. Especially when the artist who do this is watching me. Like that. Or actually, I think that her upper lip should be even darker. I need to find some kind of color that actually goes even darker, because that isn't dark enough. I might have to go into the browns actually, then maybe. I do think that. We have the Tuscan red. That's a nice color. Tuscan red, and we need to sharpen this one as well. Oh, Mardel is also Pamela. He is such a nice guy. And he... Oh my god. No! Don't do this. He is also so modest and so sweet. Oh my god, stop breaking. I'm not, you are not that long. Prismacolor, really. Mardel really is awesome and I support him as much as I can. I have actually known him for some time now. Maybe because then we still have kept the highlight in her lips, and if we need to add more, we can go in with the white gel pen. Okay, Sharon, have a wonderful hair wash. Take care. I'll see you. Taking again this peach, which is my major skin color. Going over that pink that I put inside her eyes there. And then the light peach, which I also should sharpen. So. Yeah, and that he actually came. That is just so awesome. Like that. I think that looks quite nice. But, and we need to... Oh God, I have to move some stuff. And I need a sip of my coffee because I'm dried up. Hi, Lisette. And welcome, welcome. I need to, oops, get my coffee here. Hi, Nana. Well, thank you. I'm good. How are you? I hope that you are well, too. And not only well, but I hope that you are superb. We need a light blue, and we need a little bit dark blue. I actually want this indigo as well. It's quite hard because those eyes are actually quite small, but I think we might go in with that one as well. Oops. And let's give her brown eyes. That might work well to her beautiful hair, or that hair that she's going to get at least. So then we need that, and I need something darker. Like this. What is this? This is sepia. I think that will work. And I need a yellow because something like yellow ochre or something like that. This is, what is this? This is the goldenrod. That is a nice color. So, put all of the skins and stuff away like that. So, eyes. Now, and don't bully my small pencils, but they are all well loved. Thank you, Nana. I'm happy that you like her. So, for her eyes, my God, English is hard. For those of you who speak it, you are amazing. I have picked out sepia, sienna brown, I think, tenner di sienna, and goldenrod. Now she has quite small eyes, so it's not that much to color, but we will. I will actually try to zoom in as well, so you actually get to see it, and then I will have to pick her up. Oh, come on, zoom in. Why can't I zoom in? Oh my God, this stupid thing. Oops. I could. Then, like that maybe. So, a little bit of the darkest up right under the eyelid. Now, and if I'm covering up this highlight, or actually, you know what, I will be covering up this highlight that are there already completely, like that. Yeah, pickle. I get you, because English is hard. But then again, you also have children who speaks it, and it's just amazing how good they are. So that's it. I don't think that it light kind of shines the way I want to, so I think that we will add, actually, let's make it like we need something more yellow. This canary yellow, maybe that will help us a little bit. Like that. Then, yeah, I think that we are that one. I need something black to put inside her pupil. This one. This is just a regular black fine liner. You can use whatever fine liner that you have and you like. Actually, maybe down there, yeah, like that. Ooh, she doesn't have any eyelashes. We need to give her that as well. Oh yeah, well now you also can see all her pimples. poor girl. I will zoom a little bit out because nobody sits that close to her. Oops, I'm sorry. Just put some pencils away because now I have kind of half my pencil case out there. And this one there and this. Like that. We need a little bit more. Yeah, that does that too. So we will fill in that eyebrow as well, and we will give her some eyelashes. So I'm taking the indigo and just following the inner parts of the eyelid. Hopefully, oh, you probably couldn't see that. Thank goodness we have another eye. So I'm just following the top eyelid with the indigo, making it quite a hard shadow right under there. What medium I'm using, Kathy? Started out with some Inktense and Graphitint for my moon and my sky, and then I had some Inktense watercolors as a base for her skin. I can show you when I zoom out, and then it's just pencils on top. It is this my colors for now. This medium blue I probably should not have put in because these eyes are very small. And this is the lightest blue, it's the powder blue that I just put in there. Like that. Now if I think that it got a little bit too blue, I can either erase some or I can try to lighten it up with the white, and I will lighten it up with the white. Look. Because then I still keep the shadow inside her eyes like that. And she needs a little bit highlight in the whatever it's called inside here. Just a little bit like there, like that. Maybe a little bit under for her. I like to cover these black lines because eyes really don't have black lines. Now I can't seem to cover it with this one. This one is just a too small one, so the ink won't flow on this wax. But we have bigger ones. We have the 08 as well. So let's try to cover that a little bit up. I'm just being fairly gentle. Like that. Eyes never have black lines, so I don't like having that inside my eyes. Like that. And we will give her a little bit highlight. Highlight back. One dot, maybe two. One dot and two, like Now these eyes are really, really small. I will show you by putting actually my finger next to it. Now I don't have big fingers. So you can see that her eyes is just like 1/3 of my finger. We need something for her eyelashes. This one. This is just a drawing palette pen. 0.1. This one, some small there. But, and then we are going this way. When we are adding eyelashes, from the middle of the eye, the eyelashes will bend towards the ears, kind of like up there. The middle parts will go straight up, and then the the inner parts will they will bend a little bit to the nose, kind of. I don't want her to have like really full lashes because after all she is a what did we call her again? Taurus. Bull Taurus. Oh my god. And so like that, and then we have the second eye. Some small ones up there. Ooh, and down here we have like 1 or 2 small, tiny, tiny ones as well. A little bit more like that. Come on. And we have. Now I should really do her hair finished, because these eyelashes will probably go up to her hair, but for now it will do. We will add more of those later on when we are done with the hair and fix them up. We actually can give her some. I need to sit from the side. For now, so it doesn't. God, I think I added too much on this side because we don't want them to look like spider legs. And I really don't like that line there. I think that I have to try to cover that as well. And this is something I also do in some books. If the artists have put some lines somewhere where I don't like them, like that, then I remove it. This one doesn't have to be that black. I'm not erasing it completely, I'm just and maybe you can't even see that. Yes, you can. Same thing with her lips. I'm just toning the black line down. I'm not taking it away completely. Just toning it down a little bit, maybe. That one as well. Come on. Yes, there. It's working. There, now we will zoom out and we will. Okay, yeah, that's a good way, I guess. Oh, bye, Susan. Thank you for coming. So, now, what color did we use for her hair? We used that Inktense. I think it was oak, wasn't it? Because we need to fill up her eyebrows a bit. that oak yet. That's from Baked Earth. Where did I put my oak? It's supposed to be here. That's why I'm in the dark, dark chocolate, and brown. Yeah, willow. There it is. There is the oak. We need a little bit of color on that one. Where did I put my water brush? There it is. Hi Faith. Not all. If you... The moon is Inktense. The sky is Inktense and Graphitint. Theory is for now watercolors, or actually Inktense, but as watercolors. And the base of the skin is watercolors as well. Inktense watercolors. So we have a blue base of watercolor under the skin, which is pencils. So now we have to add some color on her eye. Barrels, and just adding some colors will fill them up a little bit so they don't look that thin like that. That helped a lot. When it's dry, I might go back in and add something else or some reins. So now I'm just taking this oak and just darken up some of these parts. And this here, actually this brush here is way too wet now. I'm just soaking this paper again. Oops. Don't want my moon to be. Or have this oak color. Darken around this flower or this pretty thing in her hair. Like that. But we can darken up. Oh my god, this was just so wet. Bye, Susan. Have a good night. Well, I'm sorry to hear about your knee pain, that I am. I hope that it is manageable. Oh, that pain. Isn't easy to live with, but you also have some pain which actually are manageable. It still hurts, but you learn to live with it somehow. So I'm just having this in her hair so she gets a little bit more shade, so it actually looks a little bit better before I can find a pencil and go in and work with pencil on it if I want to. So you see, Faith, I usually mix whatever I need to get the result that I want. And of course time is a matter here as well, because I can't be sitting here and working for 2 hours and really not been doing anything. So I try to find a faster way to do things as well. And of course, I love working with the ink intense and watermelon medias. Oh my god, that sounds painful. Yeah, of course, that sounds really bad. Oh yeah, and I'm so sorry for you. Now, when I'm looking at my skin now, I think this actually look like she has a really dark bugger under there. Oh my god, I have to fix it because that is something I can't live with. That can't be bad luck like that. It can be dark, and it will be dark, but it can't be that dark. So, this is more something that I guess I can live with when it's dried up. I will darken it. Well, thank you, Pickle. Yeah, I think it's fun as well. And I'm not that kind who actually can or are able to stick to just one thing. I'm bored very easily, so I kind of have to mix my mediums and stuff up. Is it dry enough now? Maybe not. Maybe I will peel it off it if I try to put it on. Yep, I did. So, back to start. We have to hide that booger. And I will cover it up later with the pencil. Just so it isn't black. She is supposed to be dark there, but God, not that dark. Oh, Diane, I'm so sorry for you. Oh, thank you, Diane. Yeah, Pickle, I have gotten it that you are kind of the same, that you are bored easily, and you kind of have to mix things up. And yeah, so what time is it? It's actually 12 for me. It's midnight, so we have been on for 2 hours. That means also that Dev is coming on after me. So I will put this away for now, or maybe I actually will color the skin off camera. And you have seen how I color the face and on the rest of her skin, like in her ears and her neck and arms. I will just use this the pencil, which are the burnt ochre, the peach, and the light peach, and color the skin in. Rest of it I will leave so we can keep working on it on Tuesday. And for those that isn't awake at Tuesday, and you can see the recording, and I will be back next Sunday. I don't know if we are done with it by then or not, but if we ain't, we will keep working on her. Because I really want to do all of this on a camera. And hopefully I have gotten the second copy of this for Tuesday, so we can have a giveaway as well. If not, then we will have that on Sunday. So thank you for coming, and thank you all for liking my picture, and and thank you to all the mods. Hi Jerry, I don't know if I did say hi to you, but if I didn't, hi. Anyways, dev is supposed to be coming on. So would you like a link to him or I guess that you all already have it. So and another line that I see that I might change is actually that black line. Now I'm starting it. I just can't stop. Come on, like that. Again, because eyes don't have black hard lines. Anyways, so now I will leave her. I will only do her skin off a So thank you all so much for coming, and thank you to Mardel Rubio both for coming and saying hi, and for making this awesome book for us. So we colored in Zodiacolor by Mardel Rubio. So hope you have a wonderful. Thank you. There is a link to Dev's channel that see all the rich art posted. Yeah, so thank you all for coming. This has been very fun. Aruna, hi. I don't think that I said hi to you, and if I didn't say hi to everybody, and if I overlooked somebody, I'm so sorry. I don't mean to, but the chat often moves kind of fast, and I'm not in English, so I'm reading and speaking in English for me is kind of harder than for many others. So I'm sorry if I don't see everything. So again, thank you all for coming. Have a good night and bye.